Hey folks, what's going on? It's Ace Blazer, and this is just a small overview video of Caesar and Gaul campaign, just in case you haven't seen any videos on it, or you're interested in seeing some more gameplay, whatever. Probably won't be putting out too many videos on this, just giving my quick opinion, maybe show a battle or two. This is my Roman campaign, and I'm really interested in this type of stuff, because, you know, you read De Bello Gallico and, Caesar's commentaries, that type of stuff, and it's all really, it's definitely one of the if you need to like get into a book, or a primary source or something, that's a pretty good book to start off with, because Caesar wrote the book for the masses, basically. It's a propaganda piece, they like to say, and pretty easy to read, even though, you know, it's translated from Latin. It's generally in very, very easy to read Latin, or something like that. His prose is very easy to read. Anyways, let's talk about some new features. Generally, the gameplay, it's all basically the same. There are some changes in the patches that are coming up, have already come up. As of this moment, there is a patch 8.1 beta, whatever, and it's supposed to help fix, well, make some fixes to the Siege AI. From what I've seen, I haven't actually played it myself, but there are some improvements, but it's still a very long way to go. Which is disappointing, I suppose, but I have a feeling that come the new year, there'll be a lot more changes. I think the strategy is for very long-term support of the game. That's what I believe. Of course, who knows what their development time would have been for this game. It could have been like, I don't know, February would have been a good time to release the game instead of September? I don't know. I'm not gonna be judge of that. But, yeah, this is the campaign map. You'll see it's just Gaul. To some it may be a bit boring because it's only two cultures, basically. You've got the Romans, and you've got, the Gauls. And, well, actually, you've got the Germans, Germanians, whatever. And, yeah. These are generally the units you've got, club levies, spear levies, because I've pushed them all the way back to Germany. This is actually kind of accurate. You've got when I intervened in the Germanic invasion against the Germans, I was kind of fighting my own war against the Arverni. Now I've put them down, and in the commentaries, the Germanian, most notably the Suebi, I believe that's called, they expanded all the way over here, or were, you know, raiding all over the place, as what, this is the Helveti province, modern-day Switzerland. The Helveti, which is, Caesar starts around here in the Helveti province, or region, is what drove, the Germanians drove the Helveti into Gaul, basically, causing a lot of disruption, and it was Caesar who basically destroyed them, and then sold all the people into slavery, and then set up a camp on the Rhine, and lots of campaigns along the Rhine to try to keep the Germanians out, the Suebi tribesmen. And that's all in the commentaries. Now, new features. You can see there's snow here, or is that rain? I don't know. You can see what season it is by checking over here, mousing over here, so it's spring, late January, spring, huh. I guess that's like gameplay purposes. Or, I don't know. You can see what we've got here. Spring, see? +2 public order, +4% morale, all units. -5% wealth from agricultural and livestock. And I'm guessing that's because all the stuff's starting to grow. It's not a harvest season yet. There's winter attrition. Winter, you generally don't want to move because, you're supposed to be hunkering down in your winter quarters, and if you do move, you're going to suffer some pretty major attrition if you're not on the roads. So I like that. That's a pretty good feature. What else does new? Oh yeah, so since it's not one turn per year, it's now 2 weeks. 2 weeks per turn? Yeah. That's like 24 turns per year. So your generals do not die as much anymore. Replenishment rates are still kind of high, I think. See, two turns. I suppose it's friendly territory. It's not my territory though. Replenishment rates are still pretty high, I think. But generally, things have been balanced more towards 24 turns a year. building times haven't really changed, which I find kind of strange. You can see that I've built a Roman city in the space of 4 years. I suppose. 4 years, it's about maybe 90 turns I've done already. Quite a bit. But yeah, you can see the effects of the rain. It's pretty cool. That's pretty much the biggest change I've found. So it really depends. It's up to you whether you like this kind of stuff or not, whether you like smaller scoped campaigns, which are, you know, only Gaul and a shorter length of time, or would you prefer like a grand campaign where you, you know, conquer Europe, conquer Asia, span 300 years of human history. Now, that's another thing I gotta mention, though, is that I am personally favorable to like a one turn per year type of thing, because that's kind of a way to keep it realistic. Like, for instance, we'll look at Medieval 2. Medieval 2 was like 2 years per turn, and the thing is that the generals were 0.5 years per turn. They aged 0.5 years per turn, so you could get generals that lived for 200 years of human history, which I found really strange and unrealistic, but for gameplay purposes, that was really good. So yeah, the problem with one turn per year type of thing is it's your generals die really fast and that kind of stuff, but at the same time, you know, you're trying to keep it a realistic type of time period to span the rise of Rome from Republic to Empire. That's really the only way to do it. If you're going to do 2 turns per year, like Rome 1 did, you basically conquered the whole Mediterranean by 200 BC. Or even, well, I don't know, between 200 and 100 BC, which is just, that's a bit too fast. I don't know, guys, it's hard, it's all these gameplay decisions. There's no doubt that it's nicer to have generals that live longer and you can actually give them some character. So this is my typical Roman army I've got here. You know, I've got legionaries, it's the first cohort. Let's see, some auxiliaries. You can recruit auxiliaries pretty easily because you've got these auxiliary buildings can build. Let's see. Yeah, it's not really that different, to be honest, guys. Legionaries are pretty much your standard unit for the Romans. The Gauls do have some new units. Not really too much, in my opinion, though. You know, you've got your... The Germanians have Bloodsworn. It's all the same, really. Let's see. The Aedui. They're my client states. Levy Freemen, Mercenary Gallic Swords, Celtic Slingers, Gallic Hunters. You do have new playable factions, though. Again, generally pretty much the same. And I don't know what it is. I feel like mods like EB, Europa Barbarorum, or Rome Total Realism, I feel like they have more unique units. And yet, when I look at their unit rosters, they're not really that different from the game here. And maybe that's because, you know, Celtic Swords and Levy Freemen, that's really... They're all the same, but somehow different. I mean, they have those units in EB as well, and you do find that they spam those kind of units in those games, but at the same time, I don't know what it is that makes it feel so bland. I'm sorry I had to say that. That's basically how I feel about it, about this whole campaign in general. It does feel like it follows Caesar's campaign and his commentaries. Like, I actually am intervening against the Germanians and pushing them back, and then my next step would be to probably pacify the rest of Gaul. Actually, Gaul is pretty much pacified now, for me anyways. Yeah, they're not too happy at me because there's this little expansionism thingamajigger. But all these guys here are my client states. It's a nice little buffer zone. I've pacified the Arverni for now. I'm guessing there's some sort of realm divide event that happens. That's really about it. Oh yeah, there's new changes to culture. It doesn't go all the way to 100% anymore. It basically, like, it's kind of a percentage of your culture in the region. So let's say, I don't know, if they've got one culture point in there, it's going to be like, I don't know, 10% of the culture is going to be Celtic or something. Like, look at this here. 12-8. I wish there was a bigger breakdown of, like, the Celtic culture. Like, what points are in Celtic culture. Then you can actually see why it's rising. You can see Celtic culture is rising and Latin culture is falling. Right. Yeah. Let's take a look at the diplomatic situation. So yeah, I've pretty much played quite a bit of this game already. I've got these guys as clients, which is pretty realistic, actually, in terms of Caesar's commentaries. Pretty hard to to build up armies, but so you gotta kind of have to rely on making client states and buffer zones, which is good. That's really how Caesar conquered Gaul, to be honest. He pacified regions, didn't really conquer them, just to be honest. And then eventually, you know, they'd be brought into the Roman fold later on. I guess I'll play one siege. Alright, I'll show off the generals we've got. Caesar, who looks like a geriatric. Look at him. Wasn't he like... how old was he? 40, 50 something when he got stabbed? So he wouldn't have been that old when he was campaigning. We've got Junius Brutus. I believe Decimus Junius Brutus was the... he's not the same Brutus that stabbed Caesar. He was a very competent general who fought, most notably, it was the battle against these guys over here, whoever these people are, naval battles, and he beat them in battle. That was the most notable thing. Who else do we have? Cassius. Gnaeus Cassius Longinus. Longinus. He is a co-conspirator of one of the assassins, Caesar's assassins, and he was later in the battle of, what's that battle, with the other Brutus, who was fighting the Republican forces against the Triumvirate of Octavian and Mark Antony and Leviticus. Oh my god, I'm forgetting all my names. It's definitely not Leviticus. It starts with an L though. Oh my god, so embarrassing. And of course we've got Mark Antony. Who else do we have? It's been a while since I've read the book, to be honest. Regulus, I don't remember what he did, but he is there too, he's mentioned. So yeah, it's cool. But the gameplay is really so similar to just Rome, the main campaign, that I'll play one campaign and basically call it quits, to be honest. Not after, you know, Napoleon and Shogun and Fall of the Samurai, those are all small scoped campaigns, and I've been craving a larger scoped campaign since at least Medieval 2. I didn't really play much of Empire. I thought I didn't like it. So I was hoping for, you know, a good large scoped game. This kind of small scope stuff, even it's kind of like more similar to Peninsular War than anything else. I don't know. Not a big fan of the small scoped games anymore. Just a change of pace, I was hoping for something larger. But for now, let's get in this one. I attack, shall we? Ooh, that's a lot of people. Can't make it. This guy can't make it. But this garrison army is huge. I think it's because it's the German capital. The Swabian capital. And it is dry. That's good for me, I believe. Start deployment. Very dark, it's hard to see stuff. Oh, this is interesting. Have I played this kind of map before? Probably. This is kind of cool. This reminds me of this scene in Rise, which, by the way, it's like a movie, really. You just sit there and watch, you don't really play anything. Alright, shall we just burst through the front? Yeah, let's try that out. It's gonna probably be pretty bad. What do we got up here? Oh, I can shoot stuff down. How about I try this? This is going to be interesting. Slingers on this side. Let's get my artillery. I wonder if the trees... sometimes when you shoot your artillery through the trees, you'll hear the stuff going through them. Like the crashing as they hit the trees. It's kind of cool. It's a nice effect. You know what? Put the guys here. Yeah, we're just gonna bash through. Let's see what happens, eh? No siege towers. Who needs siege towers? Understood. Okay. Yeah, it's a bit hard to see because it's dark. Sorry, guys. Yeah, horses. And Caesar himself. Ready? Let's go. And let's get these guys up here. Let's hope we can get some inflating fire. Can I actually move up here? Yeah, I can. Let's see if this works. Those does look pretty cool though. Could, if the AI was smart, it would have archers all along here. Can you even put? No, you can't. No, it's not accessible. That's kind of lame. That's another thing I don't really like about the siege battles, is that so many parts of the map are just blocked off. Like Carthage, for instance, you can't get to the top where the Temple of Baal is. Or you, sometimes you can, but it's really tough. Alright, there's no point in going up there. Alright. We'll just keep going until we take out these gates. Investing in the siege we are. Let's get the skirmishers. I've only got very few because I have ballistas as well. Alright, not bad. I should probably be torching them, huh? But, yeah, sure, we'll get some inflating fire on these guys. I think we can do that. Inflate. That was one of those terms you gotta kind of like, kind of tough to figure out sometimes. Like, sometimes I forget what they mean. Inflate, deflate. Same thing with, let's say, understeer, oversteer. I don't know, it's random. Alright. Gate is down.
The enemy's gates have been destroyed.
Am I taking down the... Yeah. I took down the gatehouse. Should I? I can probably take down a fort wall. Take this one down. Since my slingers will be able to fire on these guys here. I'm gonna probably light those towers on fire with my skirmishers. So can we not fire on these guys? That's kind of lame. What, do they need direct line of sight or something?
Move out!
Nope, no, what are you doing? Come on. Ah, so lame, you can't shoot from here. Man, imagine if you could though, that'd be great. Maybe if you had archers, since slingers are direct fire units. Oh, fort wall is almost down actually. Not bad. I've only got a couple shots left though. Ooh.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Alright, let's turn fire shot on here. You can stop. Come on, Onagers. Yes! Score! Alright, let's fire on this here arrow tower. I'm pretty sure this gatehouse is damaged. Yeah, it should be damaged. Alright, let's do it, boys. Should I go in Testudo? Oh. Testudo! Ace, what are you? Well, it is a siege. I should probably be attacking another point, but let's make this a little epic. Let's go through a small choke point. A nice long fight. Alright, skirmishers up front. Let's do this. Let's move you here. This is lame. Can you not fire on these guys? Alright. It looks like you can't. So I'm gonna put them up here. Supporting fire roll. I've got no space in my hard drive to show all this. Let's put Caesar over here. We shall fire on... See, these guys are expendable, so I don't really care if they die. Can we fire on these guys? Let's just check it out, because they're firing on me up here, so... What if I... Alright, let's take out these towers. So yeah, these guys have the Celtic shield of some sort. I don't know what it's called in the game files, but really good against missiles. So you can see they're getting pelted by quite a bit, but they're still not bad casualties. They've lost maybe 20 guys, so not bad. Almost done. Alright, fire damage done there. I should probably get my siege towers and assault those, shouldn't I?
We have discovered the enemy's hidden units.
Yeah, okay, we'll get a siege tower up there. We've got siege towers to spare. Yeah. Press escape to go to the advisor. Maybe I should just... sometimes it's useful. It's really annoying that...
Go away. Units have been discovered.
I really wish it'd only be voice, though. Alright, skirmishers are getting hit. Did they actually play? Fire at will, boys. Come on, fire. All right, fire. Okay, they are starting to get hurt. I'm gonna pull them back just a bit. Pull them back up front when, forced, actually. Pull them back up front when the legionaries start going forward.
Our general is under attack.
Yeah, screw Testudo, who needs it? It's assault. Germanic tribesmen. Oh yeah, we're gonna turn formation attack off since we're assaulting. We're not being defensive. Let's get a siege tower up here. I wonder how this works. The pathfinding must be awful. Oh no, I didn't take down the hole in the wall. That's my fault. I only destroyed the section, but I didn't put a hole in it.
Brave room.
That's stupid.
We have discovered the enemy's hidden units.
Oh, I lost a unit of skirmishers. That was my bad. Okay.
Legionary.
I'll actually put you in Testudo. There you go.
Follow me!
Romans, ready for
skirmishers! Yours to commanders! Now!
So these guys are fighting. Ooh, look at all these people back here.
We have discovered the enemy's hidden units.
Yeah, that was dumb of me not to get those siege towers up quicker. Probably should have. I expected to blow a hole in the wall to get another breach going, but I didn't choose the right section. Now that's a Testudo. Right, they're not in Testudo. Whatever, I'm sure the shields are still working. Wait, are they not? Seriously not going in Testudo? I wonder if that's a bug. I have to report that. Look at this one unit all by itself taking on the whole Germanic army. Whoa. That actually looks pretty cool, guys. I'm gonna take a screenshot of this. Alright. Yeah, I'll take you guys out of this too. I don't know if that still fatigues them or not. Right, we're gonna put the first cohort up here to give them morale boost. There we go. Alright, send another unit in. That's a lot of units up here. Let's zoom in here. We insert. Into the breach, lads! Once more into the breach. We pull these guys back. We're doing all right. Do I have? What does presence do? So that's something new. Recharge rate of cooldown. Ooh, we can use the whip, and then we can use. Yep. And then I've got second winds. I can use it on that. Oh, or inspire him too. Let's do that. Alrighty. Oh, siege towers are coming slowly. This thing is not doing anything. One up here. Sorry guys, I'm gonna zoom in a bit more. There I go. Try to listen for some dialogue, eh? This is a meat grinder fight right here. Guy, take down that horse. Ooh, javelins. Friendly fire javelins too. Yeah, that's a pretty cool fight. Alright, I'm actually gonna try to move these guys back if I can. I don't know if I can. It's pretty risky to do that kind of thing. Especially in this kind of fight. Ooh! Sweet! Yeah, I can't handle this. I wanna pull these guys back behind the trees. Oh, so that worked out. They only lost about 6 guys disengaging. That's good. They used to use the whip. Let's use the whip on these guys. Actually, we use the whip on this guy too. I don't usually use those abilities, but... actually remember to use them this time. Yeah, I don't think there's any chance the Germans are going to win this. We've got way too many people. What are you guys doing here? Yeah, I hope you guys are supposed to be here. Fight, fight, fight. Oh, I've got 3 units in now. I don't remember if I was supposed to do that. Oh, the freaking siege towers. That's interesting. So, okay, that's nice. Yeah, okay. So you put the siege tower here. I'm telling you to go up this breach, but you just have to go through the gate instead. Yeah, that's buggy. Pathfinding issues yet again. More fighting.
Remember your ancestor. One of our units used all its ammunition.
No chance. My veteran legionaries against your club levy. No chance. Look at these guys with axes. So the only thing that's probably killing me is those missiles. Let's see if I can do something about that. Yeah, jungle there. Yeah, let's attack those German youths. Germanic youths. Get Caesar in there? Let's dismount him. And we'll put the first corner up here. Oh, oh, oh. They're running, boys. They're starting to run. Yeah, there's not much left. I can bring the cavalry, but I don't have any. Come on quickly. I'll just attack these guys. Yeah, it's pretty much over. That was pretty simple. Is that it? Shouldn't be hit. Let's get them in there. I think there's gonna be too much going on. This guy's out. Oh yeah, there should be a whole other army in there, because this is only the garrison, right? I don't know. There's 2 armies in it, for sure. Yeah, here's the other army. Oh, Spear Brothers. There we go. We might have a fight now. We might have a fight. Spear Brothers are not really that great. I mean, you know, spears versus swords and all that. Alright, let's get them fighting. It's a pity that formation attack is so limited.
The battle is turning in our favor.
Yeah. All he's got are spears left. There's no chance. Obviously, there wasn't going to be a chance for them anyways. We do get to see some Romans kill some Germanians. Down. Let's take a quick look. Fight! Oh no! Oh! Spear through the gut. What are you guys doing? You're not coming up here, are you? What are you... Oh, yeah. Okay, come over now. Yeah, let's just blast right through you guys. Attack! Give them no water. It is a slaughter up there, my friends. What else do we have here? Caesar's coming with his troops. And then, let's bring the cavalry in. Yeah, that's it. I don't really feel like running, chasing them down. There's no point since, you know, this is a siege attack. So, end the battle. And, yeah. Waiting for replay. So, decisive victory. Only 460 men left. Killed. Or, lost, sorry. Which is, you know, to be expected. This is a veteran army. I've crafted over since the beginning of the game. Shall occupy. We want to make sure these Germans don't come back.
Ready for battle.
Pacification. 6 turns. We want culture building. Cool. Get rid of you. And get rid of you. Usually I like to put culture buildings in, which is like the yellow buildings. usually always go for these buildings. This one here, the amphitheater, that gives you a lot of public order. Always go for those in all your capitals. Okay guys, I'm gonna leave the video here, and hopefully you got a quick overview of what this game's about. And we shall see you next time.